Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope everyone is doing good. Hope everyone is staying safe. Hope that you guys are sanitizing, washing your hands when you go out and staying as safe as possible. And to all the health professionals, I hope you guys keep staying safe and helping the masses as much as you can. Hope you guys continue staying safe. Let's get into the video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the iPad Pro. So I know I talk about the iPad Pro like so much because this is like my favorite gadget like so far. This is what got me through medical school and through being a medical student intern. I take this everywhere with me, my travel buddy. We've been through the world together. Okay, so today I'm going to be talking about the iPad Pro shortcuts that one can get to do and use as time goes on. A couple of days ago, rather 2 weeks ago, I made a video where I was talking about the different types of hacks that one can use, especially on the MacBook Pro. So today, since you guys like the video, today I'm going to be talking about the iPad Pro hacks. Okay, so let's get into it. So as you can see, I'm using the iPad Pro 2017, and the first thing that I'm going to be talking about today, it's called split screen. So what split screen basically does, it opens two windows in one page. So you have your notes here and your textbook here. So how to do that is, first let's open Notability. So let's say you are taking notes on Notability, or rather looking at a textbook, and you want a video representation of what you're watching. Here I have streptococcal pharyngitis open, and with that I want to see a video presentation of it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna open Safari by going to the toolbar, then I'm gonna long press and take it to the side, and on the side I have streptococcal pharyngitis, and I can play the video as I go through the notes. So as the video is playing, I can go through my notes and maybe look at a case or so forth. So that's the beauty of being able to use split screen. While we are still on the video perspective of it, what you can also do, the second hack is going to be called the picture-in-picture function or feature. So what happens is that, let's open full page on Safari. Let's say you're watching a video on Safari, but you also want to be writing notes on the side. So what you can do is, you go to Safari, type whatever you want to watch. So streptococcal pharyngitis is what we'll be watching today. Then you open the page, full page. So you choose the full page screen, and then you look on your top left corner, you will see a square, and the square inside, which is an icon for picture. The moment you see it, you will see the video is on the bottom right corner. Then you can press the exit button and open your notes, and as you can see, you can actually move it around and play the video. So you'll be playing the video while going through a case. Say you also want to write notes while doing that, you can. So like I was saying, let's say since you've opened the video, you've opened the textbook, say now you want to take notes. So you can actually easily just do that. You can just take notes easily by opening split screen. Remember, we spoke about split screen a couple of minutes ago. So you open GoodNotes on the side, then you have your textbook, then you have your video here, and then you can write as you continue. So that's kind of a very effective way to utilize your iPad. You know, sometimes we actually don't know how powerful our iPad is until we use it to its full capacity. Okay, so the next feature that we're going to have has to also do with Safari. You know, in Safari, when you open the tab button. You can see all the tabs. Let's just add another tab here. So let's just add Google. So on Safari, let's see, we have three tabs. We know if you pinch out, then it's going to open a page. But say you have the three of them and you want to pinch out on, you want to open one of them, you actually have an option. The place where you're going to pinch out is actually where the tab is going to open. Say I want the third tab to be open, which is Google. I'm going to pinch on Google and it automatically just opens Google and it leaves the others closed. So it's kind of an easy way to get through your browsers through Safari. It's really useful. I use it almost all the time. Next hack that we're going to be talking about is called, I don't know what it's called, but we are going to call it just the copy and paste in iMessage. So let's say in iMessage you're having a conversation with someone and want to copy a picture, or you want to copy a sticker or even a text that you've spoken about earlier. So instead of going copy and paste, what you can do is you can long press on the text and then drag it to the thing. Then it's just as easy as that. You have your message or your picture and you will just continue with your conversation easily, and it works so well. Our fourth hack is going to be the weather focus. As you know, the iPad Pro doesn't show the weather focus unless you download an external app. So with that in mind, what we can do, we can actually use maps to use the weather app. So how you go about it is, the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to go to settings. When you get to settings, you're going to look for the maps, then scroll to the bottom. You're going to see map labels, always in English, that's what I choose. Then you can also choose air quality index and weather conditions. Then you go to maps. Once you open maps, as you go about your maps, you can see on the bottom right corner there is the degrees, and if you don't click on it, you will see it gives you the full weather forecast of what's happening in the place on that specific day. So if you don't want to download an external apps and you want to use weather, you can actually use maps to check your exact weather focused based on your location, which I think is a very useful feature to have, especially with the fact that the iPad Pro doesn't have a weather app specifically for it. The next hack that we're going to be talking about is on the calendar app. So with the calendar app, what you can do is you can easily just create events and move them around by long pressing. If you long press, you have YouTube, then add. Then say you decide that you don't want to do YouTube on the 27th. What you do, long press, drag. I moved it to the 31st. As simple as that. It's all about working quick and fast on your iPad, because we can save time. And the iPad is that powerful to be able to do all the small things that we usually neglect. We just use it for the basics or just for cloud. Then the next hack that we're going to be talking about is called the floating keyboard. What you can do on the iPad, you can actually have a floating keyboard by just opening whatever you want to type. On your bottom right corner, you're going to see the keyboard. You're going to hard press and then move to floating keyboard. Then as you can see, your keyboard is on the side. And so to get rid of the keyboard, all you just do is you just swipe up at the bottom ledge, and then if you long press, you can undock it. Then the next thing that you can do, you can actually split the keyboard into two. For example, it's easier if you want to type with both your fingers. You can actually just go about it like this. And I think it's a convenient thing to have on the iPad because it's big, and if you don't have the keyboard, instead of typing like this, you can type like you would on your cell phone, of which it's a generic thing that most of us are used to. The next hack that we're going to talk about is a feature that I would use, especially when I'm working with a long document. So let's say at the bottom, all you have to do is just double tap at the top, just below when the edge of the screen is, you just double tap that and everything will go straight back to the top, which I think is a very useful function, especially if you're working with long documents or on a daily basis. So those are the 9 hacks that I prepared for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and get to use your iPad to the fullest of its ability. And I have one last hack for you guys, which is for people who also use a MacBook Pro or a Mac computer and so forth. What happens if you screenshot what you're doing on your Mac? You can actually annotate the screenshot on your iPad. As long as your iPad is connected, the moment you screenshot, it's going to show an iPad sign with a pencil at the top right corner of the screen. And what you can do is you can just click on that, and then once you click on that and you check your iPad, it's going to just be so easy. You just open your iPad and then annotate on it, and it's user friendly, because once you're done, you just save it and it goes back to the MacBook, or you can just save it on your iPad, which I think is a very nice feature to have. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video, and with that said, this is the end of the video. Stay safe, sanitize, social distance, and don't forget, be safe. Stay tuned till next time. Have a good one. Cheers.